This is Deepti Ranjan and you are listening to OTV Top 10. Today is the 8th of December and here are the top news of the day. An Indian Air Force helicopter with Chief Defence Staff General Bipin Rawat on board met with an accident on Wednesday near Kunur in Tamil Nadu. As per latest reports, 4 persons were killed in the mishap that happened reportedly due to low visibility due to foggy conditions. However, there was no immediate information on the condition of General Rawat, even as the IAF said a court of inquiry has been ordered into the accident involving a M-17 VA chopper that took from the Sular IAF station. State Public Health Director Niranjan Mishra informed that as many as 982 persons from 8 different foreign countries designated at risk from Omicron variant of COVID-19 have returned to Odisha and as many as 4 persons from them have tested COVID positive. While earlier media reports quoted that several foreign returnees to the state had gone incommunicado, the state's top director clarified today that no incoming people to the state is on the run. This is what Niranjan Mishra had to say on the matter.
राज्य को जो आट रिस्क कंट्री रु 982 जन पहुंचन 982 जन भितरु 4 जन कर हमर होल जीनोम सीक्वेंस पठेजु 4 जन जाक सुस्त अछंती एकांतवास रे अछंती चिंता करिवार किछ नाय द्वितीय कथा होची आमे जणेवा कथा जे जो भेला लोकक भितर प्रतिक्रिया बगे से भेला परिस्थिति नुह जेहेतु एटा नुवा वेरिएंट ताको समस्त ऑब्जर्वेशन रखिछन्ति से रोग केते करौछि मृत्यु केते करछि कोन तार इम्पैक्ट वर्तमान स्टडी रे अछि.
The enforcement directorate has conducted raids against a former Indian Forest Service officer of Odisha in a money laundering investigation against him linked to an alleged disappropriate assets case. The agency said an SUV, a Tata Harrier model worth rupees 15 lakh and incriminating documents were seized during the searches at the residential premises of the officer Abhay Kant Pathak. The action was taken against the Prevention of Money Laundering Act. Earlier, Pathak was compulsorily retired by the Union Government on the recommendation of the Odisha government following the registration of a vigilance case of disappropriate assets against him last year. An Indian Army Jawan travelling from Delhi to Odisha was found missing from Cuttack Railway Station under mysterious circumstances. The army man has been identified as Tenzin Goba. A missing complaint has been lodged by the Indian Army at Cuttack GRP Police Station as the Jawan had remained untraceable. As per reports, a total of 150 Jawans had boarded a train at New Delhi Railway Station to Cuttack. All of them were scheduled to undertake a training program at Charbatia. However, Tenzin was found missing at Cuttack Railway Station. Indian Army officials tried their best to trace Tenzin and contact him, but so far there has been no trace of his whereabouts. The detailed information and photos of the missing Jawan has been provided to the police station. China possesses a more significant and long-term challenge to the realization of India's strategic goals, and its aggressive intent is visible in the rapid enhancement of its operational infrastructure of its air force. In an address at the seminar, Chief Marshal Vivek Ram Chaudhary said that there is a need for robust communication by New Delhi to the world that today's India is capable and most importantly they will respond at a level that deems appropriate while defining the escalation matrix. The Chief of Air Staff also said that China's hegemonic and sometimes entrapping policies can provide opportunities for India to leverage areas of both trade and defense in the Indo-Pacific region. The Supreme Court issued notice to Tripura government and police on a petition filed by 3 journalists of HW Network, against whom FIR has been lodged in connection with their news reports of the recent communal violence in the state. The top court has directed the state to file a response within 4 weeks. Senior advocate Siddharth Luthra, representing the petitioners, contended before the bench that journalists were reporting on the issue and then there was an FIR. He added that journalists have been granted bail, but then there was an FIR filed. The jurisdiction of the Border Security Force was increased up to 50 km from the border in some states with an aim to empower it to discharge its duty in the wake of use of technology like drones and UAVs. Minister of States for Home Affairs Nityanand Rai, in its written reply to a question asked by BJP's Varun Gandhi, told the Lok Sabha that these drones and UAVs generally have a long range and are being used by anti-national forces for surveillance as well as for smuggling of arms, narcotics and fake Indian currencies. It would also help in curbing the menace of cattle smuggling as smugglers take refuge in the interior areas outside the jurisdiction of the BSF. Pat Cummins has made a dream start to his career as a test captain with a 5-wicket haul on day one of the first Ashes Test at Gabba today, on a day when Australia's fast bowlers ripped through England's batting order and skitted them for just 147 and 50.1 overs. Pat Cummins shined the brightest with 5 for 38 in 13.1 overs. Captaining the Australian team in the Ashes was baptism by fire for Cummins, especially after he lost the toss at the Gabba. After a rocketing Sangeet ceremony of Vicky Kaushal and Katrina Kaif, the traditional Haldi ceremony will be performed today. Vicky Kaushal will arrive in style at the wedding venue, riding a 7-horse down chariot. On the request of the couple, the 700-year-old Six Senses Hotel Fort in Barwara has been decorated with a heritage look, as the couple wanted something natural other than the artificial decor. Vicky Kaushal would be riding a white-colored chariot driven by 7 horses. The security of the wedding ceremony venue is being looked after the company of Salman Khan's bodyguard Shera. In a bid to scale its operations in India, Meta, formerly Facebook, unveiled its new office in Gurugram, which is said to be company's first standalone office in Asia. Set in a renovated 130,000 square feet building in Gurugram, the office will host the center for fueling India's new economy and will be dedicated to training and skilling India's small business owners, creators, entrepreneurs, and local communities. The company also announced that it aims to train 1 crore small businesses and entrepreneurs, 250,000 creators in the next 3 years. That's it for today. For news in detail, visit odissatv.in, Odisha's premier destination for news updates in English. This is Deepti Ranjan signing off.